fast, stuffing them shits in the safe. Got me a spot out the way. Nigga just trying to be safe. Let's get to the sports talk.
Jason Garrett.
No, he's going to get blamed for everything, but he has been there. Look, if you've only got one win and you've been a head coach for over 10 years.
One playoff win, yeah.
One playoff win, like, come on. And that's all they... He eventually has to go. I like Jason Garrett. He's
not the
guy,
answer, right?
But
no, I think that's obvious. He's not the answer.
No,
whether he's the problem or not, he's certainly not as the solution. And he's had a decade. And he's gone through a really good quarterback in Tony Romo. And now a bright, good quarterback with Dak Prescott. And it still hasn't happened. And you're watching all these other teams in the NFL reach out to different head coaches and start having some success that they haven't had in the past. And so, yeah, I mean, listen, this offense looks completely different than it did the first 3 weeks of the season. To me, it looks like Jason Garrett has taken over the offense from Kellen Moore.
And I never want to say this because I think it sounds very stupid when talking heads who put on makeup and speak on television say this.
But we look good.
Jason Garrett seems to have lost the locker room. And I say that, they just look like a team that's uninspired. They go into this game, it looked like they never really were going to have a chance. There's a time where Jason Garrett comes out on the field with both his hands out like this, and the entire offense
just, here's the video.
His job is gone. We don't give a damn about you, pal. It's been a decade of average. We can't do it. It just seems like there's something nasty brewing down there in the Cowboys. And behind the scenes, I don't know what it is with Jerry Jones.
He is the problem. When you have an owner that's just like average, that's what your team gonna be. They gonna be an average team every year. They got a good talent on that team. A team that could win a Super Bowl. A team that could get to the playoffs every year. But they have an average coach. The owner do not want to move on from him. He want to have complete control of that team. And you already do it as an owner. He don't want a coach to take control. He want to have control of everything, how he run it. When you have that average coach, that's what you're going to get year out and year after years. You got to move on from it. There ain't no way that you have a good team every year, but the team going to be average because they have an average coach. One playoffs win. You gotta let him go. You gotta find a new coach that can get the job done. He wanna have complete control of the coaching staff and everything. You as the owner, you own the team. Let them coaches coach. Find you a new coach. Cause it seems like Dallas out of luck. If they lose again, what you gonna do then? Keep him as a coach? It's not the players, man, it's that coach. It's time for a new voice. When you get that new coach to come in, let him be the coach. Let him run that team. You as the owner. Of course you have control of everything. But that's what you want. When you want average, that's what you're going to get every year. Because you don't want to hire nobody else. And don't want nobody else to be running that team like that. So you're just gonna settle for average.
And Jason Garrett and Kellen Moore now, something has to get fixed because they're gonna be forced down our throat on national television every single week. I would like them to be good. I'm just not sure Jason Garrett's a guy to get them.
Can we say something in the interest of fairness?
He played this game without the best left tackle in football and another offensive lineman. Amari Cooper played three snaps and another wide receiver was hurt. And I know no one wants to hear this, but the Jets are a much better team than they had shown the first or at least the last 3 weeks of the season because they didn't have a quarterback. They have a good defense. I'm not suggesting that this is a loss the Cowboys should be proud of, but I do not think the sky is falling as much as people are making of it based on the fact that they lost to an 0-4 team. That was not a normal 0-4 team yesterday.
Well, I mean, those are valid points, Greeny.
Why are you laughing at
Sean Payton's
I mean, come on. That's not your average run of the
mill 0-4 teams lose their quarterback tomorrow.
Look, I called the game. I said the Jets were going to win this thing, but here's the deal, and you're right. Tyron Smith's not out there, and it's not falling. But it's the same old song and dance. I agree with the fact that, look, they're going to make the playoffs. They're going to get it on a roll at the end, and guys like me are going to believe in them. You know, they got all this talent, and then they're going to lose in the playoffs immediately.
And don't you, it's going to be just enough for Jason Garrett to keep his job.
Look, Lincoln Riley's going to get this job. I called it last year. I just missed it by a year.
Don't you want a head coach that's able to overcome losing some? I mean, it's the NFL. You're going to have to coach without your big-time players at some point. We're seeing Sean Payton do it in New Orleans. Like, at some point, your coaches have to help you over.
I say this all the time. You're going to lose your players. You got to learn how to adapt to your team, who you have on that field. Make adjustments to put your players in a better situation. But it seemed like he haven't adjusted. It seemed like he put them in mass bad possessions. He ain't adjust to nothing. He just looking like, oh, we don't have our complete players out there. So we just gonna play what we want. I understand Jason Witten is back, but everybody know third down, you're going to him. They see that coming. I understand he's back on the team. Just make him like a decoy and throw it out to a wideout. When you do the same thing, and the players are going to see that, and the coaches are going to see that on the other team, and they're going to make their adjustments and stop you from doing it. They just know that play is coming. You're making everything obvious. It don't matter who you have out there. It's about, can you make an adjustment on that team? Oh, Amari Cooper now. Now let's make your adjustments. He didn't. He did the same old, and they figured it out, and that's why the Jets won the game. Yeah, the Cowboys came back and won, but you can't start out a game like that trying to catch up. It's going to be tough to win. It could happen. You can come back and win the games, but you don't want to keep starting every game out like that from behind.
It's always going to come down on the head coach, but I can tell you this, that would be an uncomfortable plane ride, and that's one, if the owner's ever on your plane, it'd be his plane.
Yeah.
And you're on that thing, you pretend that you're asleep. But anyway, I've been there and done that.
What's uncomfortable? What about it is uncomfortable?
No, everything, because right now it's coming down on him. But it's come down on this guy for 10 years, at least. What is it, 12 years now? You've never fired him, so what the heck? He's going to be like, hey, you're not going to fire me again. This team is not awful. They just happen to get beat this game. They see what it's like when you don't have your left tackle, you don't have your receivers, against a good football team. Look, the Jets, I say a good team, a good defensive football team. And by the way, they have a real quarterback, so...
But here's a concerning part, Dan. You watch the video of Jason Garrett, right? And it's become fun Twitter fodder, but you see him trying to get high fives from his boys, and they all purposefully walk right by him and refuse to high five. Has he lost this locker room?
There it is.
And is that, there it is right here. And is that a concern moving forward? Because, yes, every October it's pumpkin spice lattes and will Jason Garrett get fired? Obviously, it hasn't. I mean, that's where we're at.
I can't speak to if he's lost the locker room, but I do know that actions speak louder than words, and I think the actions of that video tell us a lot of what we need to know, right? Like, when you, as a coach, that game was, what, three or four, that video we just saw was like 3 or 4 minutes left in the game, and it's a one possession game. The Cowboys are down 8, and he's out there trying in some way to like generate some enthusiasm or energy for his football team, and you are coming off the sidelines and not paying attention to it, that to me as an owner would speak volumes. And again, yes, it is across the board for the Dallas Cowboys, but the number one role for, or one of the many roles for the head coach, is to make sure that everyone else is doing their job. And you would argue that there's not enough people across the board for the Cowboys doing their job. And that's his number one job.
And maybe the quarterback is one of those. So I will phrase this next part of the conversation in the form of this question. If you were to propose a trade, Sam Darnold for Dak Prescott, who doesn't do it?
Oh, I'd take Sam Darnold in a New York minute.
And the, you know what? If the Cowboys were smart, they'd make that trade, and the Jets would laugh at the very notion of it. So we're talking about $40 million for Dak Prescott, who, after beating three terrible teams as an MVP candidate, there's no one would watch that game yesterday and say Dak Prescott is better than Sam Darnold. No one.
Absolutely right, Greeny. In all the stock that he had built up for himself in the first month, Dak has just been gone in the last month. And I would have never imagined making that comment, that everything he had built up, all the good.
It's like, if you want to get paid $35 million a year, you had to be that quarterback to lead your team no matter what's going on behind closed doors. You had to play like a big contract player. He's going to get the money, but they want to see, can you play good to get that contract? You can't keep letting your team fall behind. You got to be that leader. You got to be that guy to lead your team to wins. You can't win three straight games and then lose three and suspect to get paid that money. You gotta lead your guys. You gotta come out every series at least score at least two touchdowns. At least. The starter hot. Then they get everybody else going because they seen you got the ball rolling. But when you come out and don't do too much, they're gonna start looking like, should we pay him this much? That's how they gonna look at everything. That's how I feel. That's why they ain't paying me yet. They want to see what else you could do. It seemed like you slowed down a little bit after that three-game winning streak. It's like you wait. It's like you took a step back. And you know they gonna pay you eventually, but you gotta step up as a QB. Make everyone around you good when you lose your number one option. That's what the great ones do. That was the ones who get paid a lot of money. That's what they do. They make adjustments. Oh, I lost Amari Cooper. I'm going to make somebody else around me good. Like, you still got Gallup. You just got to make adjustments as well as a QB and lead this team.
And positivity that Dak had built up in the beginning part of the season is completely gone. And here's the reality. You can't go to the table and ask for $40 million and then lose on the road to an 0-4 football team. The guy in the booth wouldn't have lost that game. That's the concerning thing for me if I'm Jerry Jones.
Remember, Dan, early in the season, you were like, hey, listen, don't sign anything. And I'm like, oh, hell no. You sign it as quick as you can in case they change their mind, because you want to sign that contract. Well, stock is down on this guy right now.
I just couldn't imagine it falling so quickly.
But I told him to sign that thing.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app and for live streaming sports and premium content.